Let's look at the solution to our multiple predictions quiz. Branches are resolved in the third stage, which means that we will fetch this branch, and then we will fetch this, and then we will fetch this, and at that point, this branch will be here and be resolved. So we will cancel this and this instruction and start fetching from X and then Y. So overall, we have wasted two cycles. Note that this penalty here is the same as if the second instruction here was not a branch at all. So basically, here we actually mispredicted two branches, but the second one was mispredicted in the shadow of the first misprediction. This branch would never have been fetched if we predicted this correctly. However, the penalty is unaffected. So when we mispredict a branch, we just need to worry about getting on the correct path, and we pay a penalty for that, but we don't pay additional penalties for mispredicted branches that themselves should never have been executed because of mispredictions. Let's see why this is so. It is because the first branch here results in flushing the pipeline when it gets to the stage where branches are resolved. The branch that was fetched after it is at that time here, and the instruction A is here, and what now happens is we flush the pipeline by converting these two into pipeline bubbles, and next cycle we will be fetching X. So what happens is really, if a branch has been fetched in error because of a previous misprediction, that branch never gets a chance to cause a pipeline flush because it itself gets flushed before that. And that's why we had a two-cycle penalty and not four cycles of penalty, because technically these two were mispredicted, but really this one should never have been executed in the first place. But this one was flushed before it could trigger a flush of its own.